This session of social, we are going to start with a new chapter, that is chapter number 3, Mughal Empire. Now, have you heard about Taj Mahal?
Yes!
Okay, have you heard about Red Fort?
Yes!
Buland Darwaza?
Yes!
See, this all were constructed during the Mughal rules. Now, it was said that the Mughal rulers, they were the lover of art. They were very artistic, right? So that is why during their period many monuments were constructed. Okay, so we will start with the Mughal Empire. As I told you that Taj Mahal, Red Fort, Buland Darwaza, that is in Fatehpur Sikri, all these things were, all these monuments were constructed during the region of Mughal Empire. Now, if we talk about who founded Mughal Empire, right? Then Babur, he founded what? He founded the Mughal Empire. Okay, he founded what? He founded Mughal Empire. His original name, his real name was Zahiruddin Muhammad Babur. What was his original name?
Zahiruddin Muhammad Babur.
Now, they fought many battles. You know that for conquering the dynasties, for conquering the places, what they used to do? They used to wage a war. So in that way, one war that they have started was the turning point of our Indian history. Right? That is the battle of Panipat. Right? Two battles were, we can say that two battles took place in Panipat. The first battle was placed among Babur and Ibrahim Lodi. Okay? From means whom? Babur and Ibrahim Lodi. Okay? So he started the first battle. And in that, as Babur was very strong, as he was very powerful, he, Ibrahim Lodi, could not conquer the place. Okay, he could not conquer the place as Babur has used the cannons. Have you seen that in war, the fireballs they used to, yes, that are what? That are cannons, right? So what he used cannons. Now Mughal rulers, who were the Mughal rulers? What was the name of the Mughal rulers? Right, they ruled for many, many long years. Right, so who were the rulers? Babur was the ruler, Humayun was the ruler, Akbar, Jahangir, Shah Jahan, and Aurangzeb. Okay, so Babur, Humayun, Akbar, Jahangir, Shah Jahan, and Aurangzeb were the main Mughal rulers. Okay. Now, if we talk about Mughal rulers, how Mughal period started? How it started? It started by the end of Delhi Sultanate. Have you heard about Delhi Sultanate?
Yes.
Right? Delhi Sultanate. After the end of Delhi Sultanate, Mughal period started. Delhi Sultanate we are going to learn in next session. Okay? That how it comes to end and how Mughal Empire developed. Right? So after the end of Delhi Sultanate, who started ruling?
Mughal
started ruling. Now if we talk about Babur, he was very intelligent king, and not only intelligent, he was very brave. He was very brave, he was very powerful, and he was very intelligent. Now if we talk about Babur, he was very fluent. If we like we are very fluent in English or Hindi or Gujarati, right? Whatever language we are fluent in. In that way, he was very fluent in Persian and Arabic language. Right? He was very fluent in which language?
Persian
and Arabic language. Now, he was the lover of nature. He loves nature. Nature, you know, natural beauty. Right, so he was lover of nature, and other than that, he was lover of writing also. He loves to write. He was the lover of art, he was the lover of nature, and he was the lover of writing. He loves to write new things. He loves to translate new things into these two languages. He used to do that, okay? He used to translate the thing Persian and Arabic language. Okay, now it is said, listen this carefully, okay, it is said that he wrote a very famous writing, like in our religion we say that Ramayan and Mahabharat is there, right? In the same way for them, for Arabian people, for Persian, they have, means it, Babur has written Tuzuk-i-Baburi. What he has written?
Tuzuk-i-Baburi.
It is as famous as Mahabharat and Ramayan epic. It is as famous, this is also world famous, right? Right, so what he has written?
Tuzuk-i-Baburi.
Of course, if he is lover of writing, means if he loves writing, then only he can write all these things, then only it can become world famous, right? So in short, he was lover of writing. And even he was lover of art. As I told you, Mughals were very artistic. Other than Aurangzeb was totally opposite. We are going to learn about him in detail, right? But first we will start with Babur and Humayun. Now we will talk about Humayun. Humayun was the son of?
Babur.
Humayun was the son of?
Babur.
Okay, of course, hierarchy was going on. What hierarchy was going on? The eldest son or the son will get the power or get the throne to rule, right? So after the death of Babur, who started ruling?
Humayun.
Now it is said that Humayun, it means lucky. Humayun means what?
Lucky.
Like lucky charm. But he was lucky, but he has to face many difficulties. He had faced many difficulties. Now he fought many battles with Bahadur Shah of Gujarat and Sher Shah. So they both were very powerful. Bahadur Shah of Gujarat and Sher Shah, they both were very powerful. And if we talk about Sher Shah was a great reformer. Reformer means he has done many things for the people, for the welfare of people, right? So that is why we can say that both were very brave rulers. So he had to fought many battles with what? Sher Shah and Bahadur Shah. Okay, Bahadur Shah of Gujarat. Now, Sher Shah defeated Humayun. Now, Sher Shah was a Bihari ruler. Okay, he ruled in Bihar, Sher Shah. Right, so Sher Shah defeated Humayun and captured the place Kannauj. We have learned about Kannauj, right? Captured the place Kannauj, right? So Sher Shah defeated what? Sher Shah defeated Humayun. Now of course defeated means harana, right? So after that Humayun escaped means what, you know students? Right, so he escaped to Iran. Where he went?
Iran.
And at that time, at that period, we can say that the throne, not exactly throne, but the handling of that particular place was under Sher Shah, right? As Humayun escaped, no ruler is there. Humayun escaped, right, to Iran, but with the help of Iranians. What? With the help of other rulers of Iran, he re-established the places. Re-established means he again captured the places, right? And he conquered the place, that is Kabul and Kandahar. Now before, in the ancient period, there was no difference between this Pakistan and India and all, right? All the bordering, we can say that that country is called India only. So Kabul, if we talk, it's not in India, right? But then also he conquered Kabul and Kandahar. And even he was like his father, he was fond of reading and writing. Right? He was same like his father. He loves to read, he loves to write. Okay? And even he was lover of art. Now other than that, he started constructing his own town near Delhi, and that town was as Dinpana. What it is known as?
Dinpana.
So he established a new town in Delhi, that is Dinpana. Now how he died, you know? He didn't die in the like war or something like that. He went to the library. He was getting down, so he fell down from the steps. In that way, Humayun died. You come to know how he died, right? This much is clear to you about Babur and about Humayun is clear to you, everyone.
Yes.
Okay, students. Now we will learn about Sher Shah. We will learn about Sher Shah. Now, as I told you that he was ruling in Kannauj or Bihar, right? Now, he was a Muslim ruler. What? He was a
Muslim ruler.
And his real name, original name was Farid Khan. What was his original name?
Farid Khan.
Okay. Now, after defeating Humayun, defeating means? Harana, right? Defeating means what?
Harana.
So after defeating Humayun, he started ruling the places over Delhi, right? Now, as I told you that he was a great reformer. Reformer means a person who used to do a lot of changes, right? In the region, in particular area. So he was a great reformer. He stopped the practice of bandits and robbers. The bandits, have you heard about the word dakus?
Yes.
Right? So bandits and robbers, there were many robbers in that during that time, right? So he stopped such practice. He introduced strict law for the bandits and robbers, right? And even he started new postal system. What he started?
New postal system.
Postal system is for communication, for what? Exchanging the letters, okay? For exchanging the letters, right? It is a way of communication. So who started it?
Sher Shah
started new postal system. And for traders and pilgrims, you know who are the pilgrims? Pilgrims are the pilgrimage is a place where one can visit and do the prayers. Right? For example, if you go to the temple, then that place will be a pilgrim place for you. Right? So he did a lot of reforms for the traders also and for the pilgrims also. Trader. Trading means what? To export and import goods from one place to another. Right? So during his time, even trading was very good. Right? From other countries, they used to export and import the goods, right? And even he introduced the currency, the rupee. What he introduced?
Rupee,
right? And even he was having a huge army force. What he was having?
Huge army force,
right? He was having what? Currency. What?
Currency.
He introduced what?
Rupee,
right? Currency, that is rupee. And even he was having a huge army force. And even he started establishing a highway. What he started?
Highway,
right? That highway was known as Grand Trunk Road. Which road?
Grand Trunk Road.
Okay, so what he established? He established a highway. Okay, from Bengal to North India, northern part of India, right? So this is about what Sher Shah. Today we have learned about Sher Shah, Babur, Humayun and about the introduction of Mughals. Okay, in next session we will start with I will talk in detail about Mughal rulers. Till that, keep learning, stay home, stay safe.